So at the beginning of the 20th century, God appeared many times to the great apostle of divine mercy, Saint Faustina. And in one of the visions she received from the Lord, there was the image of God the Father in the heavens, in a great cloud. And below him, just above the earth, was Jesus Christ crucified. And God was sending his angel of wrath to strike the earth in his justice. But the angel couldn't strike the earth because of the mercy of Christ on the cross. And it was at that moment that the Lord revealed to Saint Faustina the devotion to his divine mercy, inviting all of humanity to call upon the mercy of God in these great times to avert God's justice and wrath. So our Lord is actually asking us in these times to become the greatest saints in the history of the church, and to do so by uniting the devotion of the two hearts of Jesus and Mary. We might ask ourselves, what exactly does that devotion entail? Well, Our Lady has been telling us through her heavenly messages, particularly at Magogore, that God is asking for five themes. The first is faith, to pray for faith, to have faith. Our Lady says, without faith, nothing is possible. Secondly, she says to pray. She often says, pray, pray, pray. But she's specifically saying we should pray with our hearts, united to the two hearts of Jesus and Mary. She says, through prayer, we can obtain everything. Now, she specifically asks for daily Bible reading in the home with the family, for daily Mass when possible, and to pray every night with the family, the daily family rosary. She says, don't wait until prayer becomes a joy, but to pray until prayer becomes a joy. And what heavenly wisdom she gives us. Three, she asks for fasting. The church has always been devoted to fasting. In the Old Testament, Moses fasted, Elijah fasted, Daniel fasted. We know the apostles fasted. The early church fasted, particularly on Wednesdays and Fridays. And so Our Lady is asking us to renew, to be purified again, to turn away from the world and materialism, our passions and pleasures, just for a time, to go in self-discipline and control, and so to do so by fasting on bread and water on Wednesdays and Fridays. Fourth, Our Lady is calling us ultimately to total conversion to Jesus and Mary. She says, abandon yourselves totally to God. Be converted. Turn away from the world. Turn back to God. Decide for God against Satan and the world. She then promises conversion will be easy for those who want it. Monthly confession is the best way to be converted. And Our Lady even says monthly confession will be the remedy for the church in the West. And finally, she says, that if we engage in a life of faith and prayer and fasting and total conversion, that will lead us finally to a life of peace. And not only that, that will become a channel of peace to the whole world. She says your responsibility is to accept divine peace by living these heavenly messages in devotion to the two hearts. Peace, peace, peace is the gift of the two hearts in our time. Our Lady is coming as our loving mother, and she says to us, dear children, if you only knew how great my love for you is, you would cry with joy. In 1917, when the Blessed Virgin Mary appeared to the three children of Fatima, she gave them three secrets. The third secret was revealed by John Paul II in the year 2000. And it's a vision of the angel of God's wrath about to strike the earth because of the sins of humanity in our time. And yet, in the middle of that moment, the Blessed Virgin Mary herself stops and intervenes and holds back the hand of God's angel, calling out to humanity to a time of penance. The vision continues, showing down now on the earth. The Holy Father himself and the remnant of the faithful following behind him, going through a war-torn city, demolished, and everything destroyed. And yet as they make their way through the city, all around them are corpses. Those that are spiritually dead among humanity because of their sins. And as they make their way through the city, up a hill where there's a roughly hewn cross, all of a sudden, the Holy Father and many of the faithful are killed. And angels of the Lord then come down and pick up the blood of the martyrs and sprinkle it upon all of humanity, the corpses, the faithful. And this finally will usher in, as the vision ends, a great era of peace for the world. So we truly are being called to become the greatest saints of the latter times. St. Louis de Montfort, in his great book, True Devotion to Mary, prophesied about the saints of this time. The great saints of the latter times shall surpass all other saints in history, in sanctity, full of grace and zeal. These holy persons shall be chosen to match themselves against the enemies of God, who shall rage on all sides. They shall fight, overthrow and crush the heretics with their heresies, the schismatics with their schisms, the idolaters with their idolatries, and the sinners with their impieties. They shall be little and poor in the world's esteem, but they shall be rich in the grace of God. In union with Mary, they shall crush the head of the devil and cause Jesus Christ to finally triumph and reign in the world. They shall be the true apostles, he says, of the latter times. Jesus is sending his mother throughout the world today in various apparitions, not only to warn us, but to give us great hope about what is coming. This can be seen in a dream that St. John Bosco had concerning our time. In the dream, he saw a great ship with a pope at the helm, and the bishops and the priests and the lay faithful on the main deck. And they were out in the midst of a great storm. And the Pope was trying to guide the ship in between two great pillars that rose out of the ocean. The first, mightier than the other, had the Eucharistic Jesus at the top. The second, less mighty, had a statue of the Blessed Virgin Mary. So as the Holy Father is trying to lead the mother ship to anchor her safely between the two pillars, all of a sudden appears another fleet of ships who begin to engage in combat against the mother ship. And eventually they go alongside her and infiltrate into the church herself. One of them even strikes the Pope and he is wounded. But after he recovers, sometime later, another one strikes the Pope again. And this time, the Pope is martyred. Just as the enemies of the church think they have won the great victory, a new Pope takes the helm and he safely secures the mother ship between the two great pillars of the Eucharist and of the Blessed Virgin Mary. All of a sudden, the sea is calm, and all the other ships line up and join the mother ship in this great period of peace.
Fight, children of the light, Our Lady says. The few can see, fight. For now is the time of all times and the end of all ends. Our Lady of La Salette calls us today. Will we respond? We'll respond now to the five stones to crush evil and sin and bring about the triumph and the reign of the two hearts, the era of peace, and become the greatest saints in the history of the church. I hope so. God bless.
Oh yeah, don't forget to buy the book. And maybe a couple more for your friends too.